exercise is called the half kneeling hip flexor stretch with a shin press. This is much better than the traditional hip flexor stretch where you just engage the core and move into a lunge. We're actually going to use some tension in the body to help release these muscles that create a lot of tightness in the front of the hip, which can cause lower back pain and you feeling like you're tight in your hamstrings. I'm going to show this to you from the side first, and then I'll move forward so you can see what it looks like from both angles. You're going to need a soft pad to kneel down on, so if you don't have a cushion, just grab a pillow and get your knee towards the front of it, and we're going to want the toe pointing away from you. You're going to go ahead and bring your other leg so that it's bent to 90 degrees at the knee, right in front of your hip. So we don't want it way out to the side over here for the first part of this. We want to create an anchor in the upper part of the hip flexor, so we're going to bend forward. I'm going to pull my belly button back towards my spine and come up and tighten my right butt cheek. Now, if you already feel a stretch here in the front of this right hip, you're already in phase one. Here, all you need to do is just push your right shin down into the pad, stay proud in the upper body, arms are relaxed at the side, and just keep pushing that shin down, and you should feel that intensify the stretch there. If you get into this position and you don't feel that, just keep your core engaged, keep that butt cheek tight, move the left knee forward till you feel a stretch, and then go ahead and press that shin down. You're gonna go through 2 to 3 full inhale and exhales, pushing the shin down into the pad, and then on your next exhale, you're gonna move your left knee forward, keeping the butt cheek and the core engaged to intensify the stretch here, push the shin down and repeat. After 2 to 3 full inhale exhales, you're gonna actually do that one more time. So you're gonna do three separate increments, keeping the core engaged, pushing the shin down, and making sure that you're breathing through that entire range of motion. Okay. From the front, it would look like this. I have this leg right in front of me, knee bent to 90 degrees. I'm gonna bend over, pull the belly button back, squeeze the butt. That's the first part. The second one, we're gonna go ahead and take that foot and move it just to the outside of the thigh. Toe is still pointing straight ahead. I'm gonna re-engage my core, pull my belly button back, come up, squeeze that butt cheek tight, and then I'm gonna angle this knee out towards the side of my pinky toe out here. So I'm actually gonna move that stretch off of the fibers that are right in the front of my thigh to more the inside. Once I feel a stretch here, again, I'm pushing that shin down hard into the pad while I breathe, and maintain a nice, tall upper body. Full inhale, exhale, breath cycle 2 to 3 times. Pushing that knee out to the side, squeezing that butt tight, pushing the shin down again. And then for one last increment, pushing that knee out to the side again, and pushing that shin down while I breathe. This can be a little bit uncomfortable, but it's one of the best ways to create more permanent stretch in these muscles, because when you press the shin down, you're expanding the amount of release that you're going to get in that area.